Krishna, so many things.
My obeisances.
My obeisances. All glories to Prabhupada. All glories to your service. Om Jnana Timurandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namane Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Precharine Nirvishesha Shunyavari Paschatya Deshatarine Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasati Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Jai Jai Sri Chaitanya, Jaya Nityananda.
Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda
Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhaktavinda
Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhaktavinda
Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda
Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda
Jaya Dvaita Chandra, Jaya Gaur Bhakta Vrinda.
Jaya Dvaita Chandra, Jaya Gaur Bhakta Vrinda.
Jai Jai Sri Chaitanya, Jaya Nityananda.
Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya, Jaya Nityananda.
Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhakta Vrinda
Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhakta Vrinda
So we are traveling with Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in South India. Lord Chaitanya has his servant Krishna Das with him.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 有他的仆人 Krishna Das 和他一起旅行.
And they, after leaving Ramananda Rai, they traveled to many holy places, and they came to a very big temple called Sri Rangam.
在离开了 Ramananda Roy 之后呢，他们一起朝拜了很多圣地，然后他们就来到了一个被称为叫Sri Ranga的很大的庙里。There's
the deity of Lord Ranganath.
在这里呢，有主 Ranganath 的神像。Lord
Ranganath is form of Lord Vishnu, or Lord Narayan, laying and is a reclining form.
那么主 Ranganath 他是有主 Vishnu 或者说是主 Narayana 的形象，是一个神性的形象。
Yeah, and he's in a reclining pose.
Sorry,
he's,
I can't
hear. He's in a reclining pose.
他是处在一个 reclining.
Yeah, it means he's laying down.
Oh, okay. 他是处在一个就是睡着的这样一个形象的形象。Yeah,
you know, like when you lay down and you may have your elbow up and supporting your head.
那比如说当你在睡下的时候呢，是要把这个胳膊肘给支起来，然后用胳膊肘来撑着自己的头。I
see sometimes they have Buddhas like that. They have some Buddhas also in that reclining pose, you know.
Yeah, 那有的时候呢，我看见咱们就是这个佛陀这个佛像，它也有这样的睡着的形象。
So Lord Narayan, he's worshipped in that form in Sri Ranga.
所以说呢，主Narayana在 Sri Ranga就是这样的一个形象被崇拜着。
The devotees from the Ramanuja Sampradaya, who are called the Sri Vaishnavas, all generally they're supposed to worship Lakshmi Narayan.
那来自于Sri
Ramanuja Vaishnavas, who are
also, 那从这个 Ramanuja 传系的被称为叫 Sri Vaishnava 的这些奉献者，他们要崇拜的是Lakshmi 和 Narayana 的形象。
But we often find that they worship Sitaram.
但是我们发现呢，他们也经常会崇拜 Sitaram.
It's more common to see them worship Sitaram than to worship Lakshmi Narayan.
其实呢，更常见的是看他们崇拜 Sitaram 的形象，比他们崇拜 Lakshmi 和 Narayana 的形象。
Anyway, they consider the Ramanuja Vaishnavas, they consider Lord Narayan to be the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
无论如何呢 ，Ramanuja 这些Vaishnava 这些奉献者们，他们认为呢，主 Narayana 是至尊人格首神。
And they think Krishna is one of the avatars of Narayan.
而 Krishna 呢是主 Narayana 的其中的一位化身。
But we don't agree with that.
但是我们不同意这一点。
We say no. Krishna is the supreme personality of Godhead.
我们说不 ，Krishna 才是至尊人格首神。
And Narayan is one of his one of Krishna's expansions.
而主 Narayana 呢，它只是 Krishna 的一个扩展。
So how can we argue about this?
但是我们怎么能够去辩论这一点呢
？So Lord Chaitanya was staying at Sri Rangam, and he was staying with these Ramanuja Vaishnavas.
所以主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他就驻足在Sri Rangam， 并且呢，他和这些 Ramanuja Acharya 的 Ramanuja Vaishnava 们住在一起。
You will know the Ramanuja Vaishnavas by their tilak. They have They have a red line in the middle of the tilak coming down their forehead. On either side is a yellow line, and in the middle there's a red line.
那我们可以通过他们在额头上涂的 tilak 来辨认他们是 Ramanuja 的 Vaishnava。那他们这个 tilak 是这样涂的，两边呢是黄色的 tilak， 然后在这黄色的 tilak 中间呢是有一道红线。
And the red color represents Lakshmi, the goddess of fortune.
那这道红线呢，所代表的就是 Lakshmi， 代表的是幸运女神。
No, we are very friendly with them. We have a good relationship with these people. We don't argue with them.
那我们呢，和他们有非常友好的关系，所以呢，我们和他们是非常友好相处的，所以呢，我们不会跟他们争论。
Maybe you remember some years ago.We took some Chinese devotees, we all went to Tirupati when they were having the installation of 8 gopis in Tirupati.
那大家可能还记得在几年以前呢，我们带着一些奉献者去了 Tirupati 这个地方朝圣。那当时呢，在 Tirupati 这个地方呢，他们正在安放八位 gopi.
At that time, the installation of the deities was done by Ramanuja Vaishnavas.
那当时呢，这个对神像的安放仪式就是由 Ramanuja 的 Vaishnava 们完成的。
And Prabhupada, in his purports in Srimad Bhagavatam and in Chaitanya Charitamrita, some often quotes Ramanuja Charya.
而且呢，Srila Prabhupada 在《圣典薄伽瓦坛》以及在《Chaitanya 经》中的要旨里，经常就会引述 Ramanuja Acharya 的话。
Because Ramanuja Acharya is a Vaishnava, and we are also Vaishnavas, so we agree that we're all servants of the Supreme Lord.
Because Ramanuja Acharya is Vaishnava, and we are also Vaishnava, so we all agree that we are the servants of the Supreme Lord.
So Lord Chaitanya was staying in the home of Venkatabhatta, and they were often talking with each other and.Joking with each other sometimes.
那 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他就住在 Venkatabhatta 的家里面，然后他们经常会一起聊天，而且经常会一起开玩笑。
So Lord Chaitanya, remember yesterday we talked about Lord Chaitanya said, Lakshmi is a very chaste woman. Why does she want to go to Krishna?
那我们在昨天的课里面，我们已经讲到了，我们说到 Lakshmi 女神呢，她是一位非常贞洁的女子，可是她为什么想要去找 Krishna 呢？
She's the consort of Lord Narayan. Why did she go to Vrindavan to try to get association with Krishna?
因为她是 Narayana 的妻子伴侣，所以她为什么要去 Vrindavan 去找 Krishna 呢？
So, can anybody answer?
所以有没有哪位奉献者可以回答这个问题？
他想成为主的奉献者，他想成为公主的奉献者。
She wants to become the devotee of Lord Krishna.
She's already a devotee.
她已经是一位奉献者了。
She's the goddess of fortune.
她是幸运女神。
她想成为无量无量。
She wants to be a gopi.
Why?
为什么呢？
因为她想参加主的这个逍遥活动，逍遥时光。
So is that chaste or unchaste? Because she's supposed to be a chaste woman. Why is she going with another man?
但是这个意味着她到底是贞洁呢还是不贞洁呢？因为她是一个非常贞洁的女子，但为什么还要去找别的男人呢？
Her husband is Narayan. Why is she going with Krishna?
她的丈夫是 Narayana, 她为什么要去找 Krishna 呢？
Krishna, 因为 Narayana 和 Krishna 是一个人。
Thank you. Yes. Nisha Shay?
Charu Chitra.
Hanha. Yes. Yes, they are the same. Yeah. Venkatapata said they're the same. Krishna, Narayan are the same.
Venkatapata 就说呢，他们是一个人。Krishna, Narayana, 他们是一个人。
But there are some differences.
Some 但是呢，他们俩是还是有一些区别。
What's the difference?
他们的区别是什么
呢？
I think the Maji said that one is original and the other one is expansion of the other.
No, I want to know the difference.
Yeah, 我想知道 Krishna 和 Narayana 之间的区别是什么。
他们俩的区别。
Krishna, 他们的区别是他们所具有的品质不一样。Krishna 具有64项品质，然后 Narayana 具有60项品质，因为它是它的一个扩展，它是 Krishna。
你知道他们四个品质是什么？
一个是 Krishna 的鼻音，一个是 Krishna 和他奉献者的逍遥时光，还有一个是 Krishna 的最美，还是最具吸引力的。然后还有一个是，还有一个是什么？还有一个，我一着急一下忘了另外一个了。上演的逍遥时光最具吸引力的。
Always with his devotees, he's very beautiful, performs wonderful.
他总是和他的奉献者在一起。
Yes, right. Okay. So, yeah, those are four special qualities unique to Krishna.
所以呢，这是 Krishna 和 Narayana 不一样的四项他独有的品质。
But in simple language, to put it in a very simple way, we can simply say Krishna is more playful than Narayan.
但是如果我们要是非常的简单的把它给说出来的话，就是说 Krishna 要比 Narayana 要更加好玩。
Krishna enjoys playing with all his devotees. He likes to enjoy pastimes with them.
所以呢 ，Krishna 他就喜欢和他的奉献者们非常尽情的上演逍遥时光，
but,
非常快乐的逍遥。
With Lord Narayan, everything is very formal and according to rules and regulations.
而对于和主那亚那呢，所有的一切都要非常的正襟危坐的进行，然后所有的一切呢都要去遵守规矩。
嗯 ，So devotee Venkatabhata, he's a Ramanuja Vaishnava, and he thinks Narayan is the supreme personality of Godhead.
那Katabhata 呢，他是一位 Ramanuja Vaishnava， 所以呢，他觉得 Narayan 呢是至尊人格属神。
So Lord Chaitanya wants to correct him.
所以呢，主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就想更正他。
And he tells him that actually Lord Krishna is the supreme personality of Godhead.
所以呢，是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就对他说呢，其实啊，主 Krishna 才是至尊人格首身。
And he said this is stated in all the Vedic literatures.
然后他就说呢，所有他说这个呢是在所有的伟大文献里面全都是这么陈述的。
Lord Narayan is the opulent form of Krishna.
而主那亚那呢，是主 Krishna 的一个富裕的形象的展现。
And he can attract the minds of the goddess of fortune.
那他可以吸引幸运女神的心意。
And all the followers of the goddess of fortune, they are also attracted to Lord Narayan.
而所有的幸运女神的追随者呢，他们也都被主那亚那所吸引。
But what about the gopis?Are they attracted to Lord Narayan?
但是 Gopi 们是怎样呢？他们是被主 Narayana 所吸引吗？
We hear about the goddess of fortune. She's attracted to Krishna.
幸运女神呢，她被 Krishna 所吸引。
And Venkatabhata, he said, well, Krishna and Narayan are the same.
但是当 Katabhata 他说 Krishna 和 Narayana 他们俩是一样的。
So there is no fault on the part of the goddess of fortune.
所以说呢，对于幸运女神这一方面来讲呢，她其实是没错的。
But then Lord Chaitanya said, well, what about the gopis?Are they attracted to Narayan?
然后主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 又说，那这些 Gopi 们，他们是不是也被主 Narayana 所吸引呢？
The Gopis are attracted to Krishna. Are they attracted to Narayan?
他们被 Krishna 所吸引，那他们是不是也被 Narayana 所吸引呢？
你们说什么？
大家怎么回答这个问题？
不一定吧。
Not necessarily to be attracted、
right.
by Lord Narayana.
Yeah, and there's a pastime to illustrate this.
那就这一点呢，有一个消时光就讲了。
Krishna was hiding from the gopis.
Krishna 当时呢在躲开 gopi， 把自己从 gopi 那藏起来。
Sometimes Krishna plays his tricks, you know, he goes and hides, he'll run away from the gopis, and the gopis are looking for him. Where is Krishna? Where is Krishna?
那有的时候呢 ,Krishna 就会这么捉弄这些 gopi 们，他就会把自己给藏起来，然后呢这 gopi 们就会找 Krishna， 就会在想，就会一边找一边问 Krishna 在哪儿啊 ,Krishna 在哪儿啊。
So, one day when Krishna was hiding from the gopis,He played a trick. He took the form of Lord Narayan. He became Narayan with four arms.
那有一次呢，当 Krishna 从 Gopi 身边藏起来的时候呢，他就耍了这么一个花招，然后呢，他就让自己显现成了四臂的主 Narayan 的形象。
So then the Gopis all came running, and they saw Lord Narayan.
然后呢 ，Gopi 们就跑过来，然后他们因为 Gopi 们他们一直在跑，然后呢，他们就看到了主 Narayan 呢。
What did they do? Radha Priya, Tamasoshama, Munio Gunyan, Kandao Junarayan, Tamasoshama.
Hare Krishna, Gurudev. 然后他们就顶拜主 Narayana, 因为他们看到的是主而不是 Krishna, 所以他就向他顶拜。但是他知道这个不是他们要找的 Krishna。
以后他们问 Junarain 什么？
他们问 Junarayana， 你看到 Krishna 在哪儿吗？然后他们向 Junarayana 去询问 Krishna 在哪儿。
Yeah, very good. Yeah, that you see, the gopis, they see Lord Narayan, they offer obeisances to him. They don't think, they're not attracted to him the same way they're attracted to Krishna. It's a different relationship.
所以呢，当 gopi 看到 Junarayana 的时候呢，他们会向 Junarayana 顶拜，但是呢，他们对于 Junarayana 的这种吸引和与他们被 Krishna 所这个吸引是不一样的，所以他们之间是有不同的关系的这种展现的。
So this shows something very special about the loving dealings with Krishna, which is not there with Lord Narayan.
那所以说呢，这里面呢就展示了他们和 Krishna 之间的很特别的爱的关系的互动。但这种爱的关系呢，是在 Junarayana 那儿是没有展现出来的。
So this shows that Krishna is superior even to Lord Narayan.
所以这个呢，就显现出了主 Krishna 要比 Junarayana 要更加的高一筹。
And it's stated also in Srimad Bhagavatam, in the first canto, in the third chapter of the first canto.
在圣典婆迦瓦坛的第一篇的第三章里面也描述了这一点。
Ite chamsa kalapumsa krishnastu bhagavan swayam indriyani vakulam loke ridayanti muge muge. That Lord Krishna is not just an avatar, but he is the source of all the avatars. He is the supreme personality of God.
主 Krishna 他并不是一位 avatar 化身，他是一切 avatar 的源泉，他是至尊人格首神。
So in some sense there's no difference between Krishna and Narayan, but in other sense there is a special attraction in Krishna.
所以从某种意义上来说呢，主 Krishna 和主 Narayana 之间是没有任何区别的，但是从另外一些意义上来说呢，主 Krishna 的确是要比 Junarayana 要更加的具有吸引力。
And Krishna is more, even more attractive than Lord Narayan.
主 Krishna 要比 Junarayana 更加的具有吸引力。
Krishna attract, okay. But I mean, we explained this with the example that Krishna attracts the goddess of fortune, but Lord Narayan cannot attract.The gopis.
所以我们在这里举的这个例子呢，就是 Krishna 他可以吸引幸运女神，但是 Junarayana 却没有办法吸引住 gopi 们。
So, like this, we can give these kind of arguments to explain to people.That actually Krishna is the original supreme personality of Godhead.
对呢，我们就可以这样的方式，用这样的这种辩论的方式去向人们解释，实际上主 Krishna 他才是至尊人格首神。
Some people think, oh, because Lord Narayan has four arms, so he must be greater than Krishna. Krishna only has two arms.
因为有些人觉得主 Narayana 他有四臂。所以呢，他一定要比 Krishna 要更加的伟大，因为 Krishna 只有两条手臂。
But it doesn't work like that. That's not how you. That's not a good argument.
但是呢，这道理不是这么讲的。这么说其实是没有不是一个很好的辩论。
So Lord Chaitanya, he talked to.The Ramanuja Vaishnavas and Bhatta, Venkata Bhatta, he told them these arguments and explained to them Krishna is the supreme.
对呢，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就以这样的方式在和 Ramanuja 的 Vaishnava 们在进行着讨论。他对 Bhatta Bhatta 说呢，这个展就是以这样的例子来说明 Sri Krishna 他要更加的高等。
But Lord Chaitanya was a little worried that maybe that the Ramanuja Vaishnava will feel too upset that, you know, that Lord Narayana is not the Supreme Lord. So he wants to make them happy.
但是水车丹尼玛法布呢有点担忧，因为他觉得他这么一说了以后呢，就会让这些Ramanuja的Vaishnava就会感到很气恼，因为他们听到说，主Narayana并不是至尊人格守神，所以呢，水车丹尼玛法布呢就决定要做点什么，让他们开心起来。So
he told Venkatabhata, he said, actually, the scriptures tell us there's no difference between Lord Krishna and Lord Narayana. They're both of the same form.
那对呢，他就对本卡特巴塔说呢，其实啊，在经典里面告诉我们，Sri Krishna 和 Sri Narayana 他们其实没有什么区别，他们其实都是至尊的形象。
And there's no difference between the goddess of fortune and the gopis. They're also of the same form.
而且呢。 在幸运女神以及Gopi之间呢，也没有任何的区别，她们其实也是处在同样的形象中的。The
goddess of fortune enjoys Krishna's association through the gopis.
而幸运女神呢，是通过Gopi们来享受着和Krishna之间的联谊的。And
if we make a distinction between one form of the Lord and another form of the Lord, that becomes an offense.
那如果我们要是去区别对待主的不同的形象的话，那我们就是做出了冒犯。All
the forms of the Lord are transcendental.
所有的形象都是超然的。But
the Lord appears in different ways to different devotees.
但是呢，主他在不同的奉献者面前以不同的方式显现。The
Lord is one. But he has many forms just to satisfy his devotees.
主只有一位，但是呢，为了要令他的奉献者感到心满意足，他会显现成各种各样不同的形象。But
all the forms of the Lord are transcendental.
但是呢，主所有的这些形象都是超然的。Now
sometimes people ask us, that when we chant Hari Rama, who is this Rama? Is this Balarama or is this Ramachandra?
有的时候呢，有人就会问我们，当我们在唱诵，Hari Rama的这个Rama的这个mantra的时候，在这个 Hari Krishna这个 mantra 里面，这个 Rama 它指的是哪一位 Rama？ 是指的是主 Balarama 还是指的是主 Ramachandra 呢？And
we may say, you know, we may say, oh, Rama means Balarama, Krishna's brother.
我们也许可能会说，哦，这里面的 Rama 呢，指的是主 Krishna 的哥哥，主 Balarama。
But the other person may get angry and say, No, how it can be Balarama? This is Lord Ramachandra, Lord Rama.
但是呢，听话的那个人呢，可能就会由于这个答案而感到气愤了。他说，这怎么可能是主 Balarama 呢？这位是主 Ramachandra。
Some, because people, I was saying South Indian, they like to worship Lord Rama. Many people worship Lord Rama, Ramachandra with Sita. So we say Balarama, they say, no, Ramachandra, not Sitaram, not Balarama.
因为我们说了，在南印度呢，很多人他们都是愿意去崇拜主Rama，主Ramachandra，Sitarama。所以呢，当我们说这个曼陀罗里面所唱的是主 Balaram 的时候呢，他们就会马上反对。不不不，说的根本就不是 Balaram， 说的是 Rama， 主 Ramachandra。
But there's no difference between Balarama and Ramachandra. They're both the Supreme Lord.
但是事实上，主 Balaram 和主 Ramachandra 之间实际上是没有任何区别的，他们俩都是至尊主。
If we make a difference, then it's offensive.
那如果我们要是把他们区分看待的话，那也就意味着我们是在冒犯。
But at the same time, we should understand the Lord is different from the forms of the demigods.
但与此同时呢，我们也应该理解主和半神人的形象是有别的。
The demigods, their forms are material. They're not on the level of the Supreme Lord.
半神人他们的形象是物质的形象，他们并没有处在至尊主的层面。
So, the Lord has the Lord's form is one, right? Advaita, we say Advaita. Advaita means one. But Ananta Rup has many forms.
那所以呢，主他的这个形象是 Ananta Rup， 也就是说呢，他有很多的展现。So
according to the different meditations, the different devotees, the Lord will appear in different forms.
所以说呢，根据不同的奉献者，他所进行的不同的这种冥想。
Just like sometimes you get the valuable jewel and it reflects different colors of light come through it and you see different colors.
就比如说有的时候呢，你会拿到一个很珍贵的珠宝，然后呢，这个珠宝它的各个面就会折射光，就是不同的颜色的光芒。
So it appears different, but it's the same.
那它展现出来好像是不一样的，其实是一样，其实是一个。So,
Venkatapata, when he hears all of this from Lord Chaitanya, he said, I'm just a simple man, I don't know all this philosophy. You're Krishna, you're God Himself, you know, I don't know all this.
所以呢，当Venkatapata他听到Sri
cannot understand Krishna's pastimes. They are all transcendental.
我没有办法理解Krishna的逍遥时光，所有的这些逍遥时光都是超然的。
But whatever you say, I accept that as the truth.
但是无论您跟我说了什么，我都把它接受为真理。I
am a servant of Lakshmi Narayan, right? He was a pujari in the temple there in Sri Rangam. So he said, I'm their servant, and due to their mercy, I've been able to see you and see your lotus feet.
因为他是在Sri Rangam 庙里面的一位 pujari， 所以呢，他说，因为我是在崇拜主 Narayan 的和 Lakshmi Devi。 那就是由于他们的仁慈，所以呢，才导致我能够机会能够见到您。And
so it was your mercy that you told me all the glories of Lord Krishna. Otherwise, I would never have heard all this.
而且在您的仁慈之下呢，您就告诉我了所有的这些关于 Krishna 的信息，否则的话，我根本就不可能有这机会听到所有的这些信息。By
your mercy, now I understand that devotional service unto Krishna. Is this highest worship?
而且现在在您的仁慈之下呢，我就了解了，对于主 Krishna 的奉爱服务，那么是最崇高的奉爱形式，最崇高的崇拜形式。Because
you've told me all of this, you have made my life successful.
而且就是因为您告诉我了所有这些信息，您使我的生命变得成功了。So
then Venkatapata fell down at the lotus feet of. Lord Chaitanya
Mahaprabhu.
And Lord Chaitanya embraced him. So the Chaturmasya came to an end, and when the 4 months of the austerity was over, Lord Chaitanya took permission and he went to see Lord Ranganath and got permission from the deity and began to go more to south into South India.
所以呢，现在这个Chaturmasi四月步行的这个日子呢，也接近尾声了。所以呢，主Chaitanya Mahaprabhu呢，就到了这个，又是Ranga庙里面去拜见神像，并且呢，请求得到神像的允许，能够离开这里，并且继续去朝拜南印度的其他的圣地。
Venkatapata didn't want to leave Lord Chaitanya, but Lord Chaitanya made him go home and sent him back and said, you have to stay at home. So when Lord Chaitanya left, Venkatapata fell down unconscious, he fainted.
所以呢，当Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 离开以后呢，Venkatapata他就倒在了地上，失去了知觉，晕了过去。So
this was Lord Chaitanya's pastimes in Sri Rangam.
对，这就是Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 在Sri Ranga 所上演的逍遥。
So then, Lord Chaitanya is moving around, going to visit different places, and on the way he meets some devotee, he meets some sannyasi.
然后呢，释迦牟尼佛呢就开始四处的游走，然后去了不同的地方，而且呢他还见到了一些sannyasi。
He met one sannyasi called Paramananda Puri.
他见到了一位sannyasi，他的名字是Paramananda Puri.
Lord Chaitanya spent 3 days talking about Krishna with him.
释迦牟尼佛呢，花了3天的时间和他一起共同的讨论Krishna的话题。
Lord Chaitanya told him, come and visit me in Puri, we can have more time together, talk about Krishna.
然后释迦牟尼佛邀请他说呢，等你有时间的时候呢，来Puri，这样的话呢，我们就有更多的时间可以一起来探讨关于Krishna的话题了。
So this is the business of devotees, to talk about Krishna. You meet another devotee, you discuss topics of Krishna.
对呢，这就是一位奉献者他需要做的事情。那么，当他见到另外一位奉献者的时候呢，相互之间要讨论的就是关于Krishna的话题。
Lord Chaitanya is traveling. He's just depending on Krishna. Sometimes he gets invited to take a meal at a Brahmin's house, and sometimes he will cook.
那所以，释迦牟尼佛在旅行的时候呢，他是完全依靠于 Krishna 的。 他有的时候呢会被某一位婆罗门邀请到家里面去用餐，但有的时候呢他会自己做饭。So
then he came to a place, and after Sri Rangam, he came to a place called Madurai.
然后在 Sri Rangam之后呢，他来到一个叫Madura的地方。
The deity there is called Meenakshi, the deity of Durga.
那么在这个地方的这个神像呢，被称为叫Meenakshi。
Lord Chaitanya would visit all the temples, not just only the Vishnu temples, but all the temples.
所以，释迦牟尼佛他不仅仅是参拜Vishnu的庙宇，他会参拜所有的庙宇。
But of course, he knows how to respect the different deities.
但是呢，他知道如何去向不同的神像致以敬意。
When we offer respects to the demigods, we see them as representatives of Krishna.
那么，当我们在向半神人们致以我们的敬意的时候，我们把半神人们看成是Sri Krishna的代表。
So we offer our respects to them because they're very high, they're very close to Krishna. They have.
因为他们的地位非常的崇高，他们和Krishna也非常的接近。 所以说呢，我们要向他们致以敬意。But
we know they're not the supreme.
但是我们知道他们并不是至尊。So
Lord Chaitanya went to one temple of Lord Rama, and there he met some Brahmana who invited him to his home.
对呢，所以释迦牟尼佛呢就去参拜了主Brahma的神庙。那在那儿呢，他就见到了一些婆罗门，这些婆罗门呢就邀请他到他们家中去做客。Yeah.
This one Brahmana, he was a very good devotee, and he had studied a lot of scriptures about Lord Ramachandra.
那么当时，其中有一位Brahmana，这位婆罗门呢，他是一位非常好的奉献者，而且呢，他研读了很多的关于主Ramachandra的经典。
And he was very detached from material activities.
而且呢，他也非常的弃离于这些物质的活动。
So Lord Chaitanya took his bath in the river and then went to take his meal at the Brahmana's house.
所以呢，释迦牟尼佛呢，首先先在河中沐浴，之后呢，就到这位Brahmana婆罗门的家里面去用餐。But
when Lord Chaitanya came to the Brahmana's house, he saw that nothing was prepared. The Brahmana had not cooked anything.
但是呢，当他来到这位婆罗门的家里的时候呢，他发现。 这位婆罗门根本就没有做任何的餐食，所以在家里边没有吃的。So
Lord Chaitanya asked him, he said, why have you not cooked? It's already midday, it's already the midday time to take meal. Why haven't you cooked anything yet?
对呢，所以释迦牟尼佛就问他，现在已经都是中午了，要吃饭的时候了，为什么到现在为止还什么都没有做呢？
So the Brahmana said to Lord Chaitanya, he said, "Oh my Lord, we are living in the forest."
然后这位婆罗门就对主持坦尼亚马婆布说，哦，我的主啊，因为我们是住在森林里。
We can, for the time being, we cannot get all the ingredients for cooking.
所以呢，在此时呢，我们没有办法得到烹制食物的食材。
He said, "I'm waiting for Lakshman to bring all the vegetables and the fruits and roots from the forest."
Oh, 我在等着 Lakshman 从森林里面把所有的这些果实啊，还有这个食材呀、叶子啊都给带来。
And Sita will do the cooking when Lakshman brings everything.
那然后 Lakshman 把所有的这些东西准备好以后呢 ，Sita 来做饭。
So Lord Chaitanya understood this Brahmana was doing a special type of meditation.
这样呢，就使得释迦牟尼佛就明白了，这位 Brahmana， 这位婆罗门，他在进行一种很特别的冥想。
Because Lord Rama had spent time many years in the forest in exile, so the Brahmana was cooking in the same mood.
因为主 Ramachandra 他被流放到森林里面很多年的时间，所以说呢。这位婆罗门他也是以同样的这种心绪在做饭。
So when Lord Chaitanya heard about this, he was very happy. He was very pleased. He thought this Brahmana's method of worship is very good.
所以当时释迦牟尼佛还不听到这一点的时候呢，他内心非常的欣慰，他很开心，因为他觉得这位婆罗门的这种冥想方式是非常好的。
So after quite a long wait, finally the Brahmana.Started to cook. Lord Chaitanya, he got his lunch about 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
对呢，在等了很长时间之后呢，终于这位婆罗门就开始做饭了。所以呢，释迦牟尼佛马哈布到下午三点才吃上午饭。
But the Brahmana, he fasted. He didn't take anything. So Lord Chaitanya asked him, "Why are you fasting? Why are you so unhappy? What's wrong?"
但是呢，这位婆罗门他却戒食，他并没有吃饭。所以说呢，主持丹尼亚马布就问他：“你为什么要戒食啊？你为什么看着这么伤心呢？到底发生了什么事情？”
And the Brahmana said, "I have no reason to live. I should give up my life."
这位婆罗门说：“我没有活着的原因了，没有任何活着的理由。我觉得我应该让自己赶紧自杀。”
I will enter into fire, or I will drown myself.
那我要让自己被火给烧死，或者是我淹死自己。
Mother Sita, the mother of the universe, has been touched by Ravan.
Sita 母亲，这宇宙的母亲，被 Ravana 给触碰了。
Mother Sita is the goddess of fortune, but somehow this Ravana has touched her. So I feel very bad about this.
Sita 她是宇宙的母亲，但是不知怎的，她被这个 Ramana 给玷污触碰了，所以我现在觉得非常的难受。我觉得这件事让我想起来太难受了。
So because of this, I cannot continue living. My body is burning.
那就因为这个，我没有办法再接着活下去了，我浑身都在灼烧。
But still, my life is not leaving.
但是我现在依然还活着。
So Lord Chaitanya talks to him and he says, "You shouldn't think this way. This is not proper. You're a pundit. You don't have to think like that."
虽然爸爸说，是释迦丹娘妈妈不说呢，你不应该这么想，这么想可不对。那你是一位 pundit， 你不应该以这样的方式去想问题。
Lord Chaitanya told him, "Sita Devi is the wife of Lord Ramachandra, and certainly she has a spiritual form. No one can see her with material eyes."
释迦丹娘妈妈说 ，Sita Devi 是主 Ramachandra 的妻子，那么毫无疑问呢，她是具有灵性的形体的，没有任何一个人可以通过物质的视力见到她。
Yeah.No material person can touch her because she's
spiritual.
没有任何，
Sorry, 因为他是灵性的，所以没有任何一个物质的人可以碰得了他。
A person with material senses cannot even see her.
一个只是有着物质感官的人，根本连看都看不见他。
There's no way they can touch her.
所以呢，那就不可能碰到他。
When Ravan kidnapped her, he kidnapped only her material illusory form.
所以当 Ravan 绑架她的时候，绑架的只是她的物质的虚幻的形象。
And when Ravana came before Sita, she disappeared. She didn't stay in front of Ravana.
而且呢，当 Ravana 来找 Sita 的时候 ，Sita 就消失了。所以呢，他根本就没有让自己留在 Ravana 面前。
But to cheat Ravana, to cheat him, she sent an illusory material form.
但是为了要骗 Ravana 呢，所以呢，他就派来了自己的虚幻的形象。
So, you have to understand the pastime correctly.
所以说呢，你必须得正确的去理解这个小时光。
Do not give yourself trouble unnecessarily.
对呢，不要没有必要的给自己找麻烦。
Don't think in this way any longer.
不要再这么想了。
So when the Brahmana heard Lord Chaitanya speak like that, so he accepted food and he changed, you know, and this, his life was saved.
所以呢，当这位 Brahmana 听到 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 这一番话之后呢，他就开始吃东西了，这样呢，他的命就保住了。
So later on, Lord Chaitanya came back there.
后来呢，是释迦牟尼佛又回到了这个地方。
He first of all he left and he went to visit many different places. And while he was
首先呢，他先
while he was traveling, he came to a temple. And he found in that one temple, he found a book with the commentary with the words about the different places.With the words of the Ramayana, copies, you know, transcriptions of the Ramayana. He found one book called the Kurma Purana.
那后来呢，释迦丹尼玛巴布因为他又去了很多其他的这个地方，然后呢，他来到了一个庙里面，然后在这个庙里面呢，他找到了一本书，这本书呢被称为叫 Kurma Purana, Kurma 往事书。那这本书呢是对罗摩衍那
Yeah, and in that Kurma Purana, it described about how Mother Sita was protected.
在这本 Kurma Purana 里面就解释了 Sita 妈妈是怎么被保护的。
Mother Sita is the mother of the three worlds.
Sita 妈妈她是三界的母亲。
And she's supreme among all chaste women. She's the most supreme.
那么在所有的贞洁的女子中呢，她是最至尊的。
So when Ravana, the Kurma Purana describes that when Ravana came to kidnap Mother Sita, she took shelter of the fire god Agni.
在这个 Kurma Purana 里面就解释了，当 Ravana 来绑架 Sita 的时候呢 ，Sita 他就托庇在了火神 Agni 的庇护下。
And the fire god covered the body of Mother Sita.
而火神呢，他包住了这个 Sita 妈妈的身体。
So Ravana could not touch Sita.
这样呢，就使得 Ravana 根本就碰不了 Sita。
So in the Kurma Purana, it describes how Ravan kidnapped a false form of Mother Sita.
在 Kurma Purana 里面就描述了 Ravan 他如何绑架了假的 Sita 的形象。
So the fire god Agni took away the real Sita.
然后呢，Agni 神火神他就带走了真的 Sita.
And he brought Sita to the place of Parvati and Goddess Durga.
他呢就把 Sita 带到了 Parvati, Durga 女神的面前。
And then he brought the illusory form of Sita to give to Ravan.
然后呢他又把这个 Sita 的虚幻的这个形象呢就给了 Ravana。
So this way Ravan got cheated.
就这样 Ravana 就被骗了。
Then Ravana was killed by Lord Rama.
然后呢 Ravana 被主 Rama 杀了。
And then after Ravana was killed, then Mother Sita was released and she was brought before the fire god Agni to be tested.
然后这主 Ravana 被杀以后呢这个Sita 妈妈就被带到了阿格尼神的面前，然后呢，由火神来进行对他的考验。
They want to test her chastity. They want to, because she's been touched by another man, then she won't be chaste.
因为呢，他们想要来测试一下希特的贞洁度，因为他已经，如果他要是被另外一个男人要是触碰了的话，那也就意味着他不再贞洁了。
So the illusory Sita was put before the fire.
所以这个虚幻的 Sita 的形象呢，就被带到了火神的面前。
And then the illusory Sita form disappeared, and the real form of Sita came.
然后这个虚幻的 Sita 的形象呢，就消失了，真正的 Sita 显现了。
So when Lord Chaitanya heard this, he was very pleased and he remembered about that Brahmana before who was the devotee of Lord Rama.
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 听到这个消息以后呢，他就很开心，这会儿他就想起了当时的和他这个一起探讨的那位主 Ramachandra 的追随者婆罗门来了。
So he got the Brahmana's permission. And he got the copy of the Kurma Puran, he got the manuscript, he took the original manuscript. First of all, they made a copy and gave it to the Brahmanas there. But the original was taken by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Okay, 然后呢 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他就得到了当时庙里的这个婆罗门的同意，然后呢庙里呢他们就把这个就是这本书做了一个翻，就是做了一个复印。复印之后呢，水彩丹娘妈妈就把这本书的手稿的原件带在了身上。
Lord Chaitanya wanted the original manuscript because he thought this would be the best proof. He wants to give proof to this man that this is actual fact. It's here in the Korma Purana.
因为水彩丹娘妈妈呢，他想拿到的是这个原版，因为他觉得这个原版呢是最好的证明。他想要让之前那个婆罗门要看到这个证明，因为就这个事情呢是写在这个 Purana 里面的。Purana 里面的。
I was trying to, these copies, these texts in those days in Lord Chaitanya's time, everything is on palm leaves. So Lord Chaitanya has to get the book on the leaves and take it.
在 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的年代呢，当时是没有书的，所有的这一切呢，全部都写在这个朱里叶的树叶上。所以 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他所带的这本书呢，就是由叶子所写的这本书，叶书。
So they made a copy. They made some copies on new leaves. Got some new leaves, and they made copies to keep there. And they gave the old one. They gave the old one to this Brahmana.
然后呢？他们就又重新找了一些叶子，然后呢，就把这个Kurma Purana 里面的这个内容呢，重新的誊抄在了这个新的叶子上，然后呢，就把这个原版呢，就给了 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu， Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就给了那个婆罗门。
Yeah, and in the text it describes when Mother Sita, when Agni, the fire god, was positioned by Mother Sita, he brought an illusory form of Sita.
那么在这里面就写到了， 当阿提尼他在保护西塔妈妈的时候呢，他带来了一个西塔妈妈的虚幻的形象。
And Ravana was very powerful. He had 10 heads.
Ravana 呢，他是非常的具有威力的，他有十个头。
So he kidnapped the illusory Sita. He didn't get the real Sita.
所以呢，他就绑架了这个虚幻的 Sita 的形象，他没有真正的碰到真正的 Sita.
The real Sita went to the fire god Agni.
因为这真正的 Sita 呢，他去了 Agni 火神那里。
And Lord Ramachandra has to do the test. He has to put the illusory Sita in the fire. She enters the fire.
那么这个主 Ramachandra 呢，他就必须要经过这个试炼，所以呢，他必须要让这个 Sita 要经过这个火的这个试炼，所以呢，这个虚幻的 Sita 呢就进入到了火里面。
And then from out of the fire came the original Sita, the pure Sita.
而从火里面走出来的呢，是最原初的 Sita， 是这个纯洁的 Sita。
And she came and offered her obeisances.
然后呢，纯净的 Sita 走出来以后呢，她就向主顶拜。
So the Brahmana who is a devotee of Lord Ramachandra is very happy to get this manuscript from Lord Chaitanya.
所以呢，这位主 Ramachandra 的追随者，这位婆罗门，当他从 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 得到了这本手稿的时候呢，他特别的开心。
And he was so happy, he fell at the feet of Lord Chaitanya and he was crying in ecstasy.
他非常的开心，他跪倒在 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的莲花足下，并且呢，在极乐中哭泣。
So all the Brahmanas there were so happy, they said that Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you are Lord Ramachandra himself. You have come in the dress of a sannyasi to save us.
那么这在场的这些婆罗门们呢都非常的开心，然后他们就对 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，您是主 Ramachandra 本人，但是呢您以 sannyasi 的这个形象打扮来到我们的面前是为了要救我们。
So the Brahmana was so happy, he told Lord Chaitanya, he said, you've saved my life, you've made me very happy. He said, please come and take your lunch here today.
然后呢，这位婆罗门呢就非常的开心，他就对Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，您救了我的命，而且呢您让我如此的开心，请您今天一定要到我们家来荣耀午餐。
He said, I'm sorry, the last time you came to my home for lunch, I could not give you a very nice lunch.
他说的很抱歉，上次您到我们家来用餐的时候呢，我没有给您准备很美味的午餐。
Right, Lord Chaitanya had to wait until 3 o'clock in the afternoon before he got any lunch.
上一次呢，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 必须要等到下午三点才吃上饭。
But it said, now there's no excuse. Now we can have a nice lunch.
但是呢，这回不会有任何的借口了，这回一定让你好好吃一顿。
So the Brahmana cooked a big feast, first class dinner, served everything to Lord Chaitanya.
在这次呢，这位婆罗门他就烹制了一流的一顿盛宴，然后呢，把所有的这些美食都派给 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
So this is the mercy of Lord Chaitanya. How much he cares, he tries to help everybody.
那这就是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 所展现的仁慈，他非常的关切的想要去帮助所有的人。
Okay, so then next pastime, we hear.
我们来看下面的这个逍遥时光。
Oh, yeah.Lord Chaitanya has got this one servant with him, Krishna Das. He's very simple and very gentle.
那 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，有他的一个仆人跟在他旁边。这位仆人呢是 Krishna Das。这位 Krishna Das 呢，他是一个非常的简单，也是一个非常温柔的人。
So one time, Lord Chaitanya was traveling, and they met these people. They're called the Bataharis.
那有一次呢，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就遇到了这个被称为叫 Batthari 这样的一群人。
And these people are not very nice people. They're generally known for stealing and cheating.
那这些人呢可不是什么好人，他们一般来说呢就是会骗呐、啊，会偷，又骗又偷。
So you have to be very careful with them. Dealing with
所以说呢，和他们在相处的时候呢，一定要很小心。
So this Krishna Das somehow he got attracted, he got involved with them. They use some women, they have women with them. They dress like sannyasis, but they have women with them, and they use these women to attract innocent people.
那不知怎么的呢，这位 Krishna Das 呢就和这些人搞在了一起，然后他就被这些人所吸引。而且呢，这些人他们虽然是穿着的是 sannyasi 的装扮，但是呢，他们中间有女人，他们用这些女人呢去吸引那些无辜的人。
So this Krishna Das he got attracted with some of the women, and they brought him to their camp.
所以呢，这位 Krishna Das 他就被这群人里面的某些女子给吸引了，然后呢，这些女子就把他给吸引到了他们的帐篷里。
And they travel around. They don't have any fixed place. They're like nomads, you know. They don't stay any one place.
那这些人呢？他们是以游走形式的。他们不会在一个地方定居。
And they dress like sannyasis, but they have all these women with them.
他们穿着就像是 sannyasi 的装扮，但是呢，在他们中间还有女人和他们在一起。
So they cheat many people. Many young women are exploited by them.
那所以他们就骗了很多人，而且很多的年轻的女子都被他们欺负过。
So this Krishna Das, Lord Chaitanya's servant, somehow he got involved with them, and Lord Chaitanya thought, where is Krishna Das?
就是这位 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的仆人 Krishna Das 就和他们搅在了一起。那么 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就在想 Krishna Das 去了哪里。
And then he realized Krishna Das somehow is not with them, he's gone off. He'd gone off with the Battharis.
所以呢，他就发现了这位 Krishna Das 没有和他在一起，已经去和这些 Batthari 们混在一起了。
And this Krishna Das is from a Brahmana family, very conservative.
而这位 Krishna Das 呢，他本来是来自于一个婆罗门的家庭，而且是很保守的。
He's a Brahmana.
他是一个婆罗门。
So they got Krishna Das into their association, and they polluted his consciousness.
对呢，Krishna Das 由于和这些人一起联谊，使得这些人呢把他的知觉给污染了。
And he went there to their camp early in the morning.
他在清晨一大早就跑去他们的帐篷里。
So when Lord Chaitanya understood Krishna Das had gone there, Lord Chaitanya also went there to rescue him.
对，当 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 弄明白了 Krishna Das 去了那儿的时候呢， Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 也跑到那儿去救他。
Right, they had their tents, they had their where they were camping. So Lord Chaitanya somehow he managed to find, he knew where they were, found them, and so Krishna Das is also there.
那因为他们有他们扎营的地方，然后在这营地上呢都支起了帐篷。无论如何呢，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu呢就设法找到了这些人所这个安营扎寨的地方，然后呢他就去到了这里，然后在这儿呢就发现了 Krishna Das 在这里。
So Lord Chaitanya came there and he asked them, "Why are you keeping my Brahmana assistant here?"
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 到了这儿以后呢，就质问这些 Batthari 们说。你们为什么要把我的助手留在这儿？
You are in the renounced order of life. I am also in the renounced order of life.
那你们是处在生命的气节阶段，而我呢，也是处在生命的气节阶段。
But you are giving me pain, and I do not want to, I don't see any good in this. You're giving me unnecessary pain by taking away my servant.
但是呢，你们让我很痛苦，而且呢，你们是让我，在没有必要的在饱尝着这种痛苦，因为你们把我的仆人给带走了。
So when Lord Chaitanya challenged them like this, they got a bit upset.
所以当时这三娘妈妈不像他们这样发起挑衅的时候呢，他们就变得有点恼怒。
And they all came running with their weapons, and they had weapons in their hand, and they were like they were going to attack Lord Chaitanya.
所有的这些人呢，因为手中都持着武器，所以呢，他们就抄着自己的武器向Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu奔过来，就好像他们要攻击Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu。
But by the arrangement of Yoga Maya, all the weapons in their hands fell from their hands.
但是在Yoga Maya的安排之下呢，他们手中的武器全部都从手中掉落了下来。
And then their weapons began to beat their bodies.
而且呢，他们的这个武器呢，就开始打他们自己的躯体。
So then Bhattaharyas, they were all screaming and crying, they were getting cut, they were getting a beating.
那所以呢，这些 Bhattahari 们被自己的武器给打得惊慌的这个大声嘶叫着，疼的大声叫唤着。
So they were running and crying, there was so much confusion in the camp. And Lord Chaitanya, he took Krishna Das and took him away. And it said Lord Chaitanya took him by the hair, he had a shika.Lord Chaitanya grabbed his shika, took him away.
Because Krishna Das, he 留着 shika, so then Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就揪着 Krishna Das 的 shika 辫儿，把他给拽出来了。
So that night, they could go to a, they got away, they moved from that place, they moved to another place.
那那天晚上呢，他们就从这个地方要挪到下面一个地方去。
And then they went to see the temple of Adi Keshav.
然后呢，他们又去拜访了被称为叫 Adi Keshav 的庙。
So Adi Keshav 庙 is a very old temple, very great temple, something like Ananta Padmanabha, very ancient big temple with a Vishnu deity, a big Vishnu deity.
那这个庙呢，它是非常老的庙。那么它就像是 ，Sir Maharaj, you mentioned the other name, Atmapata.就像是这个阿玛帕塔庙一样，那么这里面呢有很古老的 Vishnu 的神像。
Ananda Padma. So this is Adi Keshav.
就是我们现在说的是 Adi Keshav 庙，它是一个非常古老的庙，然后呢，在这儿有非常古老的 Vishnu 的神像。
You can go there. It's a big temple, also a big old temple.
我们可以去那儿，然后那地方呢，它是一个很老的，但是很大的庙。
Lord Chaitanya went in and he saw the deity in ecstasy, chanted and danced.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他就进到了这个庙里面，并且参拜了神像，而且呢，他是满怀着极乐之情，在这个神像面前唱诵着圣名，并且翩翩起舞。
So there, Lord Chaitanya found the Brahmanas had a very special manuscript. They had the book called the Brahma Samhita.
然后在这儿呢，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu遇到了一位婆罗门。这位婆罗门呢，他有一个很特别的手稿。这部手稿的名字呢，被称为叫 Brahma Samhita。
So Lord Chaitanya was very happy to hear this Brahma Samhita and to read it. He he felt this is so important. This is exactly our philosophy. This is what Krishna consciousness is all about. All the teachings are there in the Brahma Samhita.
对，所以丹娘妈巴布他非常开心地读了 Brahma Samhita， 然后他就说，这个 Brahma Samhita 里面所讲述的就是关于 Krishna 知觉的所有的哲学的教义是，这是关于 Krishna 知觉的所有的这些教导全部都被涵盖其中了，所以这 Brahma Samhita 是非常重要的。
Actually, it's only one chapter which we have. It's the fifth chapter of the Brahma Samhita, but that one chapter tells everything we need about our philosophy.
但是呢，这个 Brahma Samhita 它一共有五章，可是它其中只有一章里面呢，就涵盖了关于我们需要了解的关于 Krishna 知觉的知识的所有的信息。
When Lord Chaitanya found this book, then he began to show ecstasy. His body was trembling, and he was crying, and he was in jubilation. He was dancing and chanting, and he was in so much ecstasy.
那么当时释迦牟尼佛他发现这本书以后呢，他立刻展现出来的是非常身体的各种各样极乐的这种征象。他开始他的躯体就开始颤抖起来，然后他哭泣着，然后呢，他展现出来的是非常极乐的这种征象，而且呢，也开始跳起舞来。
So because all the conclusions of our philosophy are there in that book, it's very important for our devotees.
因为呢，我们的哲学的所有的这些结论全部都涵盖在这本书里面。那么这本书呢，它对于奉献者来说是非常重要的。
Said it is essential amongst all the Vaishnava literature. It is essential.
那么它是所有的 Vaishnava 文献中的核心要义。
So, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati, he wrote purports to this Brahma Samhita.
Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur, he wrote Brahma Samhita.
And of course, that book is now published by, the BBT Press.
那么这本书呢，现在被我们的 BBT 所出版。
So Lord Chaitanya, he got a copy of this book and he took it with him.
对呢，所以释迦牟尼佛呢，他就拿到了这本书的复制的版本，然后呢，他就带着这个版本一起旅行。
Yeah, he got somebody got some brahmana to copy the whole book out, and so Lord Chaitanya copied onto palm leaves, and Lord Chaitanya packs it up, wraps it.And takes it with him to take back to Jagannath Puri to show all the devotees there.
然后，释迦牟尼佛呢就请一些婆罗门，用这个棕榈叶子把这本书给誊抄了。然后呢，他把这本书誊抄好的这个棕榈色叶子呢，很好的包起来，然后呢，带在自己的身上。他要把它带回到 Jagannath Puri， 并且呢，把它展现给在 Jagannath Puri 的奉献者看。
Lord Chaitanya also found another book.In a different place, not at Adikeshava, but in another place, he came across another book called the Krishna Karanamrita.
那所以释迦牟尼佛呢，在另外一个地方，并不是在这个 Adikeshava 的这个庙里面，在另外一个地方呢，他找到另外一本书。这本书的名字呢，叫 Krishna Karanamrita.
It's written by Bilvamangal Thakur.
那这本书呢，是由Bilvamangal Thakur 所著的。
So Lord Chaitanya brought both these books with him and brought them to Jagannath Puri.
So, in the Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he also brought this book with him to Jagannath Puri.
So, we see, we are still today, we also have these books. We have especially Brahma Samhita, we are chanting. When Prabhupada would do a fire sacrifice at times of initiation, at that time, often they would chant Brahma Samhita. Prabhupada liked to hear it chanted.
那所以Prabhupada 当他在进行这个启迪的火祭的仪式的时候呢，他就会唱诵 Brahma Samhita 里面的经文。
So it's very nice to be familiar and chant it, to be able to chant the verses.
那所以说呢，如果要是能够 熟悉这个经文，并且能够去念诵这些诗节的话，是非常好的一件事情。
And of course, every morning when we greet the deities, we play the Govinda prayers, which has two verses from the Brahma Samhita.
那每天清晨，当我们在迎请神像的时候，我们唱诵的 Govinda 的祷文，那么这也是在 Brahma Samhita 中的其中的两个诗节。
So Lord Chaitanya is traveling still, and he's in South India.
是查坦加玛哈布呢，依然还在南印度旅行。
Are there any questions?
Yes. Charu Chitra Maharaj asked, Srila Gurudev, is that okay for me to ask you a question?
Yeah. Go ahead.
Charu Chitra Maharaj, 您的问题是？
好的，好的。古鲁马哈拉的顶拜，深深的顶拜你，感谢大家听古马哈拉。我听第一个故事的时候，就是在 Rama 庙里，主持天娘见到那位婆罗门，婆罗门请他去吃饭，但是那位婆罗门呢，他自个儿戒食，因为他觉得他没有理由活着。那我想知道，这应该是卡贝年代，然后Sita 妈妈是。被 Ravana 抢劫，应该是不是在银器年代初或者金器年代末？然后这位我的问题是，这位婆罗门，是他有灵性失忆看到的这个抢劫事情的发生，还是在书上读到的，还是听到的？这个地方我没听明白。谢谢姑对，给我解释一下。Hare Krishna。
Yeah。So, Charu Chitra wants to know about, did the Brahmin actually see this incident where Sita is taken by Ravan, or is he just read it in the book, right?
Yeah. Of course, the Brahmana is in the Kali Yuga. However, Sita is in the, in the other yogas.
Yeah. So, yeah, of course, he's reading the Ramayana. And he entered into the pastime. He's affected.
那么当然呢，他是在读《Ramayana》这本书，然后呢，他让自己进入到了这段逍遥时光，然后呢，他被这逍遥时光所影响了。
Krishna 明白了。
There was a great devotee king in the past, long before even Lord Chaitanya. His name was Kulu Shekhar.
那在这个 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 之前，就是在远在 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 在世之前，有一位伟大的国王，他的名字呢叫 Kulu Shekhar.
Kulu Shekhar.
Kulu Shekhar.
Yes. So Kulu Shekhar Maharaj, he.Was also a great devotee of Lord Rama, and when he would read the Ramayana about Lord Rama going to Lanka to fight Ravan, he would also want to go.
那 Kulushekhar Maharaj 呢？他也是主 Ramayana 的一位追随者，一位奉献者。那么，所以当他听到主 Rama 要到 Lanka 去攻打 Lanka 城的时候，他这会儿就觉得，那他也想去。
And he was a king, and he had his own army and generals. So he called all the army, call everyone, we're going to Lanka to help Lord Rama fight Ravan.
然后呢 Kulushekhar 王呢，因为他是一位国王，所以呢他有他自己的将领，有他自己的军事。所以呢，当他一听说主 Ramachandra 要去 Lanka 的时候，他就召集了自己所有的军队，跟他说让咱们赶紧现在也一块要到 Lanka 去，然后呢要协助主 Ramachandra。来攻打 Ravana.
And they had to arrange, they had to send a general in front and then have him come back, and he would come back and say, oh, my lord, it's all right. Lord Rama has already defeated Ravan. Ravan has already been killed by Lord Ram. We have no need to go to Lanka.
然后呢派出这个大将，然后这大将呢还到前面去打探了军情，然后回来还向国王汇报，告诉说，哦，我亲爱的国王呀，主 Ramachandra 他已经搞定了 Lanka 之战，他已经打败了 Ravana 已经被主 Ramachandra 给杀死了，所以呢咱现在不需要再去了。
So these devotees, you know, they enter right into the pastimes of Lord Krishna and Lord Chaitanya and Lord Rama. They hear the pastimes, they actually live it. They enter right into the mood of the pastime.
为了这些奉献者们呢，他们其实是真正的让自己进入到了主 Krishna、 主 Ramachandra、 主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的逍遥时光中。那么，当他们在阅读或者在聆听到这些逍遥时光中的时候呢，他们是完全让自己身在其中的去体会的。So
hearing can be such a powerful experience. It can go to the heart that these devotees, they don't just think this is just some story, they actually think, oh, this is going on right now. Okay, so is there any other question?
No, not for now.
江大可巴布，您那边有问题吗？这边没有。Yeah,
so there was no questions for now.
Okay, so we'll continue then. So Lord Chaitanya, after Adikeshava temple, then he comes to the temple of Ananta Padmanabha.
在 Adikeshava 庙之后呢，他们就来到了 Ananta Padma。
Ananta.
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 Padma.
Padma.
Naba.
Naba. Ananta. Hatva Naba.
Yeah, these temples, they're still there. They're big temples. And this Ananta Padmanabha temple is in the city of Trivandrum. In South India, in Kerala, in the state of Kerala.
Trivandrum.
In the state of Kerala. This temple Ananta Padmanabha, they discovered just a few years ago, they discovered that in the basement of the temple there were so many jewels and diamonds and very valuable treasures, all belonging to the deity.
那么这个 Ananta Padmananda 庙呢，实际上是在几年以前才刚刚从地下被发现的。那么在这里面呢，就发掘出了有好多好多的珍贵的珠宝。那么所有的这些珍贵的珠宝宝藏呢，全部都是属于神像的，落在神像身上的。We
used to think Balaji Temple was the richest temple.
那我们以前总是会觉得巴拉吉庙呢是最富有的庙。But
this temple in Trivandrum was had much more wealth than Balaji.
但是呢，这个在 Trivandrum 的这种庙呢，要比那座庙要更加的富有。They
had several rooms all full of treasure.
这个庙里面呢，有好几间房间，这个房间里面都盛满了各种各样的宝藏。And
they were all in the basement. They've been there for hundreds of years.
而这些房间呢，都是埋在地下的，一埋就是好几百年的时间。The
kings who used to rule, they were in charge of the temple.
那么以前统治。
And they were devotees, and they would use a lot of their wealth to buy jewel, to put jewelry for the deity.
那这些国王们呢，他们都是奉献者，所以呢，他们会把自己很多财富全部都用来为神像购置这些珠宝。So
this temple was visited by Lord Chaitanya.
对的，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就拜访了这座庙。
And then he's gone down. Lord Chaitanya has already gone down to the very tip of South India. Now he's coming back up on the other coast.
那这会儿呢，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他其实已经到了很南端的地方，所以他现在已经开始又往北上了，又开始去到这个海边，就是还去到另外一边了。
And he comes to the place called Udupi.
然后他就来到了一个被称为叫 Udupi 的地方。
Oh, before Udupi, he comes to Sringiri.
但是在 Udupi 之前呢，他先来到的是叫 Sringiri 的地方。
Sringiri is the headquarters of Shankaracharya.
那么 Sringiri 呢，它是 Shankaracharya 的总部。
Right, we said Shankaracharya.He was preaching more than 1,000 years ago.
那 Shankaracharya 呢？他应该是在一千多年以前在传教。
And he had four. He made four ashrams.
他有四个修院。
One place was at Puri.
其中一个修院是在 Puri.
Bhattacharya was teaching there to the sannyasis.
Sabhavana Bhattacharya 就在那个地方传为这个 sannyasi 们传授课程。
And Shankaracharya made another ashram at Dwarka.
然后呢 ，Shankaracharya 在 Dwarka 也在那儿建了一个修院。
So one on the east coast, one on the west coast.
对呢，其中的一个呢是在东岸，另外一个是在西岸。
Then he made another one at Badrika Ashram up in the Himalayas.
然后呢，他又在这个Badri Ashram， 就是在喜马拉雅山上，他在这个地方也有一个修院。
And in the south, he made this place at Sringiri.
所以呢，在南边呢，他就是在 Sringiri 这个地方建了他的这个南边的修院。
So initially he had his four main disciples. One disciple was in charge of each place.
从最开始呢，他就有四个主要的门徒，那么每一位门徒呢，主管着每一座修院。
So they would people who would join there to become sannyas, they would go there, they'd get training there, stay in the ashram.
所以呢，来到这儿的人呢，他们会在这儿加入sannyasi， 并且呢，在这个 ashram 里面。住下来，并且在这个地方得到训练。
And after they get trained, then they go out for preaching.
当他们得到培训之后呢，他们就会出去进行传教。
So Lord Chaitanya then went to Udupi, which is the place of Madhvacharya.
然后呢，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu就来到了 Udupi. Udupi 呢是 Madhvacharya 的地方。
Madhvacharya was a disciple of Srila Vyasadeva.
Madhvacharya 是 Srila Vyasadeva 的一个门徒。
Right, Vyasadeva is a disciple of Narada.
那么 Srila Vyasadeva 呢，他是 Narada Muni 的门徒。
Narada is a disciple of Brahma.
Narada Muni 呢是主 Brahma 的门徒。
So the disciplic succession is like that.
所以呢，这就是我们这个师徒传系这样的传承。
From Brahma.To Narada, to Vyasa, to Madhvacharya.
从主 Brahma 到 Narada 到 Vyasa， 然后再到 Madhvacharya.
Madhvacharya appeared in India just about 1,000 years ago, or less.
Madhvacharya 呢，应该是在大概一千年以前在印度显现的。
Yeah, I remember just last year they celebrated the 1,000th.Birthday, the anniversary of the appearance day of Ramanujacharya.
那么在去年的时候呢，就刚刚庆祝了Ramanujacharya 的一千岁的生日。
So Madhvacharya came a little bit after Ramanujacharya.
那 Madhvacharya 呢，是在 Ramanujacharya 稍微比 Ramanujacharya 稍微晚一点显现的。
So like that.So his main temple, Madhvacharya's temple, is at Udupi.
所以呢 ，Madhvacharya 他的主要的神庙是在 Udupi.
Now Ramanujacharya, his temple was at Srirangam, his main temple.
那 Ramanujacharya 他的主要的庙呢是在 Srirangam.
And who did they worship? Who did the Ramanuja Vaishnavas worship?
那 Ramanuja Acharya 他们崇拜的是谁呢？亲爱的奉献者们，姑姑在等大家的回答。
Listen, Nij Dharma. Listen.
李欣在吗？
不在。
Yes.Yes, yes.
Ramanuja, he chung by some shen shang.
Okay.
他不在。
我想一下啊。
我们看。Charumai 你在吗？
Charumai
你知道。
Ramachandra is right?
But could be Ramachandra. Yeah, often they do worship Ramachandra. But they're supposed to worship. Who are they supposed to worship?
是这样的，就是他们呢经常会崇拜 Ramachandra， 但是他们本来应该崇拜谁呢？
Sorry, Guru, I don't know.
谁知道？
是 Lakshmi 吗？
Yes, Lakshmi. 还有谁？
还有谁
呀、
啊？
Lakshmi
Narayana.
Yeah, Lakshmi Narayana. We don't just worship Lakshmi, we have to worship her husband.
We don't just worship Lakshmi, we have to worship her husband. Lakshmi 女神，我们还得崇拜她的丈夫。
So, Ramanuja worship. So, the Madhvas, they worship.Krishna, they're supposed to worship Krishna.
So, this Madhava Acharya, his followers, are supposed to worship Krishna.
And they have the temple at Udupi. They have a very nice deity of Krishna at Udupi. It's a deity of Lord Krishna as a cowherd boy.
那这个神像呢，是主 Krishna 以牧牛童的形象显现的神像。
Oh, when Lord Chaitanya saw the deity, he became mad with ecstasy. He danced and chanted, and he was in ecstasy.
所以呢，当时 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 看到了这尊神像的时候呢，他立刻就在极乐中变得疯狂了起来。他大声的唱诵着，使劲的狂跳着舞。
So this deity of Krishna.Was actually given to Rukmini when she was living in Dwarka.
那所以这尊神像呢是，当 Rukmini 她住在 Dwarka 的时候所给予的神像。is given to Rukmini，
<Yeah.
S 2> 就是把这个神像给了 Rukmini。
Because Krishna would go out sometimes, he'd go out to visit places and leave Rukmini alone in the palace. So Krishna gave her the deity.
Okay, okay. Because Sri Krishna, he 有的时候呢要出宫，然后他一出宫以后呢，等于就把 Rukmini 自己留在宫里面。所以说呢 ，Sri Krishna 就把这尊神像就送给了 Rukmini， 让他在宫里面可以崇拜这尊神像。
So it happened that Madhvacharya one day he was meditating at the side of the ocean.
所以有一天呢 ，Madhvacharya 他就在海边冥想。
And he saw a boat. There was this boat on the ocean, and the boat was in some trouble.
然后呢，他就看见了在海洋里面有一条船。这个船呢，正在遇到麻烦。
So Madhvacharya was able to help the boat to get free and to avoid the trouble.
所以呢 ，Madhvacharya 呢，他就要帮这条船从他的这个麻烦中解救出来。
So the captain of the ship. said to Madhvacharya, is there anything I can do to repay you for your help?
那当时他帮了他以后呢，这船上的船长就对 Madhvacharya 说，我能做为您做点什么，从而报答您呢？
So the Madhvacharya said,Oh, yeah, he said, there's a big lump of Gopi Chandan on your ship. Can you give that lump of Gopi Chandan to me?
Madhvacharya 说, 说在你的船上呢有一大块 Gopi Chandan, 那你能不能把这块 Gopi Chandan 送给我呢?
So the captain arranged to get that Gopi Chandan, and they gave it to Madhvacharya.
所以呢这位船长呢就安排把这一块 Gopi Chandan 给弄了出来然后呢把它送给了 Madhvacharya
And Madhvacharya then put some water over the Gopi Chandan and found within the Gopi Chandan there was this deity of Lord Krishna
然后呢 Madhvacharya 呢他就在这块 Gopi Chandan 上放了一些水然后 Gopi Chandan 化掉以后呢就发现这里面包着一尊主 Krishna 的神像
Yes, come on. So, this deity was installed at Udupi. Still worshipped today.
直到今天还依然被崇拜着。
And they have a system. They have in Udupi, they have 8 ashrams.
然后他们有一个体系。那在乌杜比呢，一共有八个修院。
And they have a sannyasi in charge of each ashram.
然后呢，每一个修院呢，都有一位 sannyasi 来管理着。
So they take turns to do the deity worship.
所以呢，他们是相互轮换着进行着神像崇拜。
One ashram will worship the deity for 1 year, and all the other ashrams will go out for preaching.
那么其中的一个修院呢，会崇拜神像一年，那么其他那些修院的奉献者呢，就会到外面去进行传教。
And when the year is over, then they'll change over. Another ashram will come and take the turn to do the deity worship.
那然后呢，在另一年结束之后呢，他们就会换岗。那么另外一个二十万的这些奉献者呢，就会继续的崇拜神像。
So this deity of Lord Krishna is very famous, very beautiful.
Krishna 的这尊神像是非常的有名的，而且呢也非常的美丽。
And Lord Chaitanya liked very much to be there. To chant with them, to chant in the temple and dance in the temple.
那所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，非常的喜欢这尊神像，而且呢，会在这个庙里面唱诵啊，会在庙里面这个跳舞啊。
Of course, Madhvacharya was in this world a long time after Vyasadeva.
那当然，Madhvacharya 呢，他是在。Vyasadeva 之后很长一段时间在世的人。
So when Madhvacharya was preaching, some people were telling him that no, this is not right. What you're saying is not true. This is not right. They didn't accept.
所以呢，当 Madhvacharya 在进行传教的时候呢，很多人就说你说的这不对，你传的这都不对，是错的。
So.Madhvacharya went to the Himalayas, he went to Badrik Ashram.
Madhvacharya, 他就去了 Badrik Ashram, 去了喜马拉雅山。
And he went there to find Vyasadeva.
他就到那个地方呢去寻找是为了 Vyasadeva.
Because he knows Vyasadeva was staying there in the Himalayas.
因为他知道是为了 Vyasadeva 是住在喜马拉雅山上的。
Vyasadeva is in the Himalayas and he will wait there till the end of Kali Yuga.
Srila Vyasadeva 他住在喜马拉雅山上，他一直会在那儿等着卡利年代的结束。
When Kali Yuga dies over, then he will come down again.
那么当卡利年代结束之后呢，他会再下到山底下来。
So Vyasadeva he wrote all of the books for the benefit of people in the Kali Yuga.
Srila Vyasadeva 他背了卡利年代人的福祉，写下了所有的这些书籍。
You know, he knew Kali Yuga is coming and beginning, so he didn't want to stay here. He wanted to get away from the inauspicious atmosphere, so he went to Himalayas.
因为他知道卡利年代马上就要来了，所以呢，他就不想待在这儿，他不想让自己被这个不吉祥的这种氛围所污染，所以呢，他就离开了，他就去到了喜马拉雅山上。
So Madhvacharya, he went to Himalayas to find Vyasadeva, to check what he was saying, to see if what he was saying was right.
所以呢，Madhvacharya 呢，他就去到喜马拉雅山上去寻找 Srila Vyasadeva， 从而呢，能够去探明自己说的是不是对的。
And Vyasadeva also heard his teaching and confirmed everything and approved everything, then sent him back.Go back now. Go your do your preaching.
那么 Srila Vyasadeva 呢，就向他证实了他所说的这些话，然后呢，并且呢，把他又给派了回来，然后呢，让他继续进行他的传教。
So, this is, of course, this is controversial. How people have difficulty. Not everybody will accept that he could have gone there to Himalayas. That he could have met Vyasadeva.
当然了，这其实是有些矛盾的，因为并不是所有的人都能够接受这一点，并不是所有的人都能够去到喜马拉雅山上去寻找到Vyasadeva， 能够见到他。
So, this, but this is the, how our disciplic succession is explained.
但是呢，这是我们的使徒传系所向我们做出的解释。
So Madhvacharya was in this world for 80 years. He spent 80 years. He took sannyas when he was 11.
Madhvacharya 呢，他在这个世上活了80年，然后他是在11岁的时候让自己成为了 sannyasi.
Shankaracharya took sannyas when he was 6.
Shankaracharya 呢，是当他在6岁的时候成为了 sannyasi.
And Shankaracharya, he left the world when he was only 32.
那么Shankaracharya 当他在只有32岁的时候就离开了这个世界。
But Madhvacharya was 80 before he departed.
但是 Madhvacharya 呢，他是在80岁的时候才离开这个世界的。
Okay, so, when Lord Chaitanya was there in Udupi, he had some talks with the devotees, with the people there, with the Vaishnavas there.
那么当 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 在 Udupi 的时候呢，他和在那里的一些 Vaishnava 进行了一些谈话。
This, the deity, first of all, is a dancing Gopal.It's a dance, a form of Gopal dancing.
那首先呢，就是这个神像呢，它是一个在跳舞的 Gopal.
So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would also dance and chant, seeing the.
No, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他也跳舞，他也会唱诵。
He was one person. He was on his own, but still he would chant and dance.
那 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他虽然是独自一人，他只有一个人，但是他依然会跳舞，会依然会唱诵。
Now Lord Chaitanya, when he came to Udupi.The devotees in the Madhvacharya temple, they thought Lord Chaitanya was a Mayavadi sannyasi.
可是呢，当时 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他来到 Udupi， 来到 Madhvacharya 的这个庙里的时候呢，这里的人觉得是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他是一个 Mayavadi 的 sannyasi。
Anybody know why？
大家知道为什么吗？
There are some differences between the Mayavadi sannyasi and the Vaishnava sannyasi.
因为在 Mahabodhi Sannyasi 和 Vaishnava Sannyasi 之间呢是有些区别的。
One difference is in the danda, right? Mahabodhi Sannyasi they have eka danda, one danda, but the Vaishnavas they have a tridandi, they have three dandas.
其中一个呢是他们手里拿的这个danda棒不一样。那Mahabodhi手中拿的这个danda呢是eka danda, 就是一根danda棍。而这个Vaishnava Sannyasi 呢，他拿的是 tridandi, 就是由三节组成的danda棒。
Lord Chaitanya, he didn't have his danda with him because Lord Nityananda broke it.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 手里根本就没有拿担的，因为 Nityananda 把这担的棒给弄坏，就是弄断了。
So it couldn't be because of the danda that they thought. They didn't think him a Mahavadi Sannyasi because of the danda.
所以呢，不可能是因为这个担的棒是他们认为 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 是
The Mayavadis, when they take sannyas, they cut all the head, they shave the whole head, they don't leave a shika.
那么当时 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他接受 sannyasi 几级的时候呢，他是把所有的头发都给剃了，他并没有留shika。
And they don't wear a Brahmin thread also.
而且呢，他也没有戴婆罗门圣线。
But the Vaishnavas, when they take sannyas, they keep the shika and they keep the Brahmin thread.
但是呢，当 Vaishnava 的这个，当 Vaishnava 他接受 Sannyasi 的时候呢，他是会留着西卡辫，而且呢也会带着婆罗门圣线的。
嗯。So when they saw Lord Chaitanya, they thought he's a Mayavadi Sannyasi.
那所以说呢，当他们看到是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的时候呢，他们就觉得他是一个 Mayavadi 的 Sannyasi.
So they wouldn't speak to him. They didn't like to speak to him.
所以呢，这些人呢就不想跟是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说话。
But then they saw Lord Chaitanya dancing and they saw how much love he had for Krishna. Then they could understand, wow, he's really a Vaishnava. He has so, because Mayavadis, they don't have this kind of ecstasy. They don't have this love for Krishna.
但是呢，当他们真的看到 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的这种舞姿以及他这种极乐的唱诵的时候，当他们看到 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 对于 Sri Krishna 的满含的这样的爱和深情的时候，他们就意识到了 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 是一位真正的 Vaishnava， 因为 Mayavadi 是不可能对 Krishna 有这么多的爱的。
Mayavadis are like Buddhists; they cannot show any emotion. They should be. You have to be controlled. You have to subdue the emotions. Don't make any show.
那么 Mayavadi 呢，就像是佛教徒一样，就他一定要控制住自己的情绪，他不可能去展示他任何的情感。
Sometimes in Buddhist countries like Taiwan or Thailand, we have Buddhist monks come and they sit in our kirtan.
那有的时候，当我们在泰国和在台湾这些地方的时候呢？我们的 kirtan 的这个聚会里面会有一些佛教的僧侣会来到这里，会坐在我们的 kirtan 中间。
And they will sit and meditate, and we will invite them. Come on, get up and dance. No, they cannot dance. That's not allowed.
那然后呢，他们就会坐在那儿，然后呢是处于冥想的状态。那但是我们就会邀请他们和我们一起来跳舞，但他们就会说不，不行，我们不允许跳舞。
Must be sober, must control the mind and senses.
那我们必须要冷静，一定要控制自己的感官和心意。
So when they saw Lord Chaitanya dancing in ecstasy, then they thought, whoa, he's a Vaishnava. He's not just a Mayavadi, he's a Vaishnava, he's a devotee.
对，所以说呢，当他们看到 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 在极乐中跳舞的时候，他们就意识到了 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu他是一位 Vaishnava， 他是一位奉献者，他根本就不是 Mayavadi。
So their mood changed, and they gave him a very nice reception.
那所以呢，他们的这种对待 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的态度就发生了变化，所以他们就热烈的欢迎了 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu。
So Lord Chaitanya could understand that these people were a little proud of their Vaishnavism.
那么，所以 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就能明白，这些人呢，因为自己持有的 Vaishnava 宗而有一些骄傲。
So Lord Chaitanya began to stop to them, discuss some philosophy.
所以呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就开始和他们聊了起来，并且和他们探讨哲学。
So he got the the main man, the head of the community, that he was supposed to be learned, known all the philosophy.
然后呢，他们就找到了这个社区里面的最年长的这位族人，因为这个人呢，他应该是最博学的，他应该了解所有的哲学。
So Lord Chaitanya asked him, he says, I don't know what is the aim of life. I don't know how to achieve it. Can you tell me?
然后Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu说呢，我并不知道我们生命的目标到底是什么，而且我也不知道如何去坚持这些目标，你能不能告诉我呢？
So the Acharya from the Madhvas, he said, oh, the aim of life is that we should follow the four ashrams, dedicate our activities to Krishna.
那么这位 Madhva Acharya 的这位Acharya， 那他就说呢，哦，对于我们来说呢，我们应该追随这四个 ashram， 然后呢，并且我们要把我们的生命全部都奉献给 Krishna。
Yeah, the, all our occupation, varna and ashram, they should both be for Krishna.
然后呢，无论是 varna 和 ashram， 他所履行的各种职责，都应该是奉献给 Krishna 的。
And then if we do like that, then we're eligible for liberation.
那如果我们要是这么做的话呢，那我们就有资格能够获得解脱。
And we can go to the spiritual world, Vaikuntha.
那么就可以去到灵性世界，可以去到 Vaikuntha.
And so this is the highest goal.
这是最高的目标。
This is what all the scriptures teach.
这是所有的经典的教导。
But Lord Chaitanya said, well, according to the scriptures, hearing and chanting is the best means to get service to Krishna.
然后是陈丹娘妈妈说呢，根据经典的教导，聆听和唱诵才是最好的服务 Krishna 的方法。
Hearing and chanting, remembering the holy name, this is...
聆听唱诵记忆圣名。
Worshipping the deity, offering nine kinds of devotional service.
崇拜神像就是一共有九项不同的奉爱服务的方式。
This is the real aim of life.
这才是生命的真正的目标。
This is what's stated in all the scriptures.
那么这个是在经典中所陈述的所有的内容，这就是在所有的经典中所陈述的内容。
And when we come to love Krishna by these processes, beginning with hearing and chanting, then we're successful in our life.
那如果我们要是去遵循这样的程序，从聆听和唱诵 Krishna 的圣名开始，去遵循这样的程序的话，那我们的生命就能够达到成功。
When a person is actually advanced, and takes pleasure to chant the name of the Lord, then he's advanced. That's the aim of life.
Sorry. 那么当一个人真的是在唱诵主的圣名中感受到极乐的时候，那也就意味着他真正的取得了进步，在灵性上取得了进步。
Is that, oh, I think I better stop, it's getting late. Okay, we will continue this afternoon.
那我们今天下午呢会接着讲。Marge, here is one question from Subhuti Rai Prabhu. Do you want to answer now or afternoon?
Okay, no.
这有一个问题啊，是从 Subhuti Rai Prabhu 问的问题。Ramanuja Acharya 本人是不是觉得 Krishna 是原初至尊人格首神呢？还是说，只是他的追随者认为 Narayana 是至尊人格首身， Krishna 是 Narayana 的扩展呢？ For the Ramanuja Acharya himself, if he think that Krishna is the original Supreme Lord, or his follower think that Narayana, Lord Narayana is the Supreme Lord, and Krishna is the expansion of Lord Narayana.
The followers of Madhvacharya are meant to be Krishna devotees. They think Krishna...
Ramanuja Acharya. He's asking Ramanuja Acharya.
Ramanuja Acharya, I explained, they accept Narayan as the Supreme Lord.
嗯，我已经解释了 Ramanuja Acharya 他是接受 Narayana 是至尊主。
Madhva's,
so in that case, both Ramanuja Acharya and his followers believe that Lord Narayana is the original Supreme Lord.
Yeah.
对，就是Ramanuja Acharya 本人以及他的后人都认为主 Narayana 是至尊人格首身，是原初的至尊人格首身。
Yeah, and they think Krishna is the incarnation from.
嗯，他们觉得 Krishna 是化身。
Okay, that's a,
yeah.
That's a question.
Yeah, that's a question for now.
What's that? 他说什么？
请问哪位奉献者刚才说了什么？听不清楚。
Hare Krishna, Gurudev, 我想问一个问题。Ramanuja Acharya 因为他崇拜的是 Lakshmi Narayana， 所以那他的教导当中会有稳大稳的这种分离的情感吗？
Well, they have a temple in Vrindavan, but you know, for them, they don't give a lot, they don't see any particular significance in Vrindavan. They think Vrindavan is just one of the tirthas, you know, like they have many tirthas, they have 108 tirthas.Holy places which they go and visit.
嗯，那他们 Ramanuja Acharya 就 Ramanuja 的后人，他们在 Vrindavan 是有庙的，但是呢，他们并没有把 Vrindavan 当成一个很重要的一个地方，他们只是把 Vrindavan 当成是108个 Tirtha 108个圣地之一，只是他们需要去朝拜的一个圣地而已。
So they give more importance just being in South India. They have their headquarters there. They move, like I said, Sri Rangam, these places.
所以呢，他们把他们的这个注意力重点更加的放在南印度，比如说他们的总部是在 Sri Rangam， 就像我刚才所说的那样。
Okay.So we'll stop and have a rest. We'll
talk. 那我们现在的就先停在这儿，今天这节课。
Well, continue in the afternoon. Thank you very much.
下午再接着讲。
感谢丹尼里给我们精彩的翻译。
谢谢 Maharaj。
感谢所有的奉献者聆听。
谢谢 Guru Maharaj。
Hari Bo, okay, Jintan Shao Jian,
Hari
Krishna,
Hari
Bo.